what I've read in a couple of places is that, so, that they were sort of birthed out of this displacement of a lot of Indians. They were, to back up a little, there was like a, the United States passed this, I think it was called the Indian Relocation, where basically they're trying to empty out their reservations so that they could be like, look, there's not enough of you, we can have your land now. There's been all sorts of acts like that, and one of the last ones was the Indian Relocation Act, where they were like, we're gonna, you guys are poor, a really great way to not be poor anymore is to move to the city and get a job, and we will buy you we'll get your transportation into the city, and we'll set you up with housing, and we'll help you find a great job, and then you won't have to be poor anymore.
When was it?
I think 50s. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was the 50s. 1950s. So a lot of people got, but then what I've also read from the Native perspective is what that really resulted in was a one-way bus ticket to the projects. So that's how a lot of places like...
Which is land and has since been appropriated in horrible ways. Yeah.
So like Minneapolis, Chicago, I think San Francisco, there's maybe a few other cities that have like large Indian populations, and that's largely because of this Indian Relocation Act. However, I've also read in a few places, like the upside of that was that all of these like young people who were now being either left the reservation when they were really little or were then born in the city, grew up like they were part of the radicalization of the 70s, mm-hmm. and like met one another. They were from different reservations, so it was like a more pan-Indian coalition, people coming from different nations, and were radicalized. And I think AIM was started like in 71. And actually, Eric was talking about Black Elk. His nephew, Fool's Crow, Frank Fool's Crow, also Catholic, and sort of the spiritual leader for Russell Means and Dennis Banks, who were two of the more well-known like lead founders of AIM. There were others, but I can't name them right now. I don't know. But Russell Means and Dennis Banks would often go to Frank Fool's Crow for like spiritual guidance and doing like the sun dance. So Fool's Crow was like fully Lakota and fully Catholic, which was like, I think interesting. Although AIM like repudiated, they had a very negative view of religion in general, especially Christianity. So they did, I think one of their early acts was something they called the Trail of Broken Treaties. So they did like a caravan, so I forget where they started, somewhere down south, I think. And they like caravan up to D.C., where they occupied the Bureau of Indian Affairs. And I don't remember exactly why. The Bureau of Indian Affairs was like not releasing all these documents that they needed for some reason. And but anyway, they ended up occupying that office for a while and getting the documents they needed. I don't think it was AIM, but I think it was some people similar to AIM. It was more like a student movement occupied Alcatraz off of San Francisco. For like a year and a half, they occupied Alcatraz, and it sounds, from what I've read, it sounds kind of like Standing Rock, very joyful. It wasn't like an angry standoff. And they had demands. A lot of the demands are like, we want like a cultural center. We want like an Indian education center. We want like acknowledgement that this island once belonged to us, and now imprisons a lot of us. And AIM was in like a lot of the traditional like spiritual elders were kind of skeptical of AIM because of their willingness, their sort of like willingness to be like confrontational. But then in Pine Ridge, where there was a lot of violence, like a lot of Lakota were being killed by a group that actually called themselves the Goons, like G-O-O-N-S, like Dojo or something. They called themselves the Goons, and they were sort of like law enforcement on the reservation, and they were killing a lot of people. They were murdering a lot of people. Pine Ridge, a lot of the elders asked AIM to come out to protect them from the murders, and so that was when the standoff at Wounded Knee, they decided to like go, AIM decided like their tactic was to go to Wounded Knee because it was such like a, like people would remember, that book Bearing the Heart at Wounded Knee had recently come out, I think, and they knew that people would recognize Wounded Knee as like the place where this huge horrible massacre had happened in 1890. So they went to Wounded Knee and then there was a big standoff, and I think they did a lot of good in that situation. And, you know, AIM was present at Standing Rock, I don't know.
I think
So I don't, I think they're
I don't
still.
Know how I-